Guys, that section, man, how much of bleeding? Oh gosh.
You know what that reminds me of?
What?
Sauce. Ooh, samosas. Do you know who likes samosas?
Who?
Swati here.
Swati, what is this?
Oh, hi guys,
oh, hi.
Welcome to the OBGYN Gossip. And today is the International Day for Action for Women's Health. And we have with us Dr. Christy and Dr. Swati. And there's Dr. Neha, Dr. Natasha, and Dr. Anjali. And that's Dr. Rahul behind the camera.
Hi, Rahul.
Hi.
Yes, we do.
Hi.
Great Dr. Priyanka with us.
Yeah, so I believe Dr. Swati has some questions for Dr. Christy. So.
Oh, is it? What's your question, Swati?
So, sir, do you think women's health is neglected and mental health is sought only when she can't do her household work?
Surprisingly, yes. I know, like, even in this day and age, I thought things have actually changed, but it's actually not. Actually, going to some statistics, it's seen that about 600 million hours are lost just because of menstrual related issues and dysmenorrhea, and it also leads to school absenteeism in girls, especially between 13 to 18 years of age. So it's close to 50% actually in India itself. So that's kind of, yeah, I think yes, but never it's true.
And what reasons do you think for this neglect?
I don't know, it could be many things, like socioeconomic status. I think that's something you guys also see, right, in every clinics. And one is also how the perception to menstruation in men, but more so in women themselves. So I feel that the overall support they get among themselves is a bit different. I won't say it's less, but it's different in every part of the world. So even in India itself, in every state, it's a bit different. So recently I was just going through and I was speaking to, and we actually did a survey in Johns, and we actually went to, like, you know, the interior villages in South India, and we actually found out that 85% of girls prefer their mothers to speak about menstruation. And even they don't, and the very next person you'll expect is a sister or an aunt, but it's actually their friend. And they said beyond this they would not feel comfortable discussing it with anyone else. But what do you guys feel? Any other?
Yeah, that makes sense, because the topic is so taboo, people don't feel comfortable talking about it, let alone go to a hospital with a patient.
Exactly. Yeah, it's quite, even like, yeah, it is quite a taboo.
Yeah.
Yeah, hopefully that answers your question.
Dr. Neha, do you have any questions about it?
So what do you think can be done to empower women in marginalized communities?
Well, I think more than saying about empowerment, I think it is how comfortable we all are with the situation. Because, like, you know, even when I speak to patients about either menstruation or anything, you know, OBG related, I think it has to do with the level of comfort, how we are comfortable with the situation and with the topic itself.
Mm-hmm.
Because the moment you start, you know, like, categorizing it or start speaking about it in a very, you know, blasphemous way, as they would say, then you're kind of breaking the rapport and the barrier. So I think a lot of it has to be at how comfortable we are. And the moment we are comfortable with it, definitely the patient or whoever you are looking at becomes comfortable with it. But how do you all feel? Like, is there any other difference in opinion as to how you guys would manage it?
So guys, do you still think that it's like stigma around menstruation and the topics related to it?
Yes, absolutely. The age-old discrimination against menstruating women is still seen today. They're considered impure, barring them from entering temples or even kitchens. But these are seen in society, those sections of societies which are underprivileged or don't have access to education. But let's not go too far, okay? If urban developed areas also, aren't we not freely talking about
periods?
So let me ask you, are you embarrassed to talk about
periods?
But it isn't just menstrual health. There's so many health problems that women still face.
Like?
One such, I believe, is breast cancer. There's so many women who still don't know that they have to self-examine their breasts to check for lumps and to visit the doctor daily, at least regularly.
That's true.
And I believe the same goes for cervical cancer. Like, if we compare with the West, people actually go for screening, and here in India, they're so shy about a vaginal examination, they would never come to a doctor if they have any problems. So, yeah, problems do exist across the society.
So, Rahul, you're being awfully silent.
Yeah.
Well, all I can say is that this has been a big eye-opener to me. We do have a long way to go forward, and I guess this is the right way by talking about this openly. So, thank you.
Oh, so guys, that's enough OBGYN Gossip Day. Until next time. Bye!
Bye.